Hey everybody, welcome to Whiteboard Wednesdays. Remember, this is where we take apart the most complex and challenging chiropractic business profitability problems, and we take them apart on the whiteboard and we work through the solutions together. Last week, if you missed last week, we made the case for why you must implement nutrition into your practice. It was an extra long Whiteboard Wednesdays video. If you haven't seen it before you watch this week's, go back on the Whiteboard Wednesdays section of our YouTube channel and watch why is it that you must put nutrition into your practice to improve profitability through recurrent revenue. This week I want to tackle the basic five steps to implementing nutrition into your practice to be successful with it. The first thing we want to do right here is we want to stimulate demand. So how do we stimulate demand? You market your practice. You market yourself as a chiropractor, but you want to stimulate demand for the other things, the alternative profit centers that you have inside your practice as well. And so nutrition is something that you must market in order to stimulate demand for. How do we do it? Well, at Housecall, as you know, we're an internet marketing firm. So when a practice indicates to us that a nutrition is part of their practice and they'd like to have new business come into them looking to purchase nutrition and nutrition-related services from them, we stimulate demand for that practice by optimizing or search engine optimizing that practice for a variety of different keyword sets that you want to be found for to build your nutrition practice within your practice. If you haven't done so, go to the homepage of thehousecallgroup.com and request a Google rank report on your practice's website, and we'll send you a rank report not only on the 40 most important chiropractic related keyword searches, but we'll also send you on the 30 different keywords associated with nutrition and stimulating demand for nutrition in your practice. If you're working with another SEO company, that's fine, particularly if they're doing a good job for you. Make sure they're optimizing you for nutrition-related keywords so that people come in expecting and even demanding they have high-quality, branded, professional nutrition products ready to purchase from you. The second thing you want to do besides your Google keywords is social blog content. Now, if you're working with Housecall and you're a client and you've indicated to us, as we said before, nutrition's part of what you want to do, then we're already producing for you nutrition content and pushing it out onto your blog, which is connected to Facebook and Twitter and all of your social accounts. If you're not with Housecall and you'd like to join us, we'd be so proud to partner with you. But if you're just getting started in practice and you just have an office Facebook page and you're just, say, on the basic plan where we're not doing all your blogging for you and you're just paying that $50 a month for the Housecall system, then go ahead and begin to generate content and put it out onto your social accounts on the subject of nutrition. And a wonderful way to do that is through testimonials of existing patients who you've helped by changing the nutrition game for those patients. That's a wonderful way to produce content and have third-party validation that your practice uses nutrition to get people well. The second thing you got to do is intake correctly. And next week's Whiteboard Wednesdays is going to be drilling down a lot deeper on intake. If you're training inside of Profit Fuel, if you're already a Housecall client, you know how important intake is. But if you haven't gone through the Profit Fuel training yet, get this handled now. Intaking is critical because it's where you ask. If you don't ask on an intake form specific questions generally put on there to stimulate a conversation about that patient and their nutritional status and how their primary and secondary chief complaints have brought them into your practice and how they relate to nutrition and to the nutritional recommendations you're going to make, then you're really missing the boat. Your intake form is where you get to why. And as Profit Fuel clients know, that's where we get the patient to tell us what type of alternative profit centers, particularly nutrition, that we can recommend because it's going to help them with their case. Get your intake forms handled, and if you're a Profit Fuel client or a Housecall client, you've already got a downloadable intake form that covers this wonderfully inside of our site. The third thing we want to do is make sure you carry an inventory. My friends, you can't sell what you don't have. So when a patient says, yes, doc, I think I'd like to try that omega-3 fatty acid and the multivitamin and the probiotic you recommended, and you go, terrific, I'll order it for you. It'll be here in about a week. If you don't get it for them, they'll go get it somewhere else. You've got to have a reasonable inventory on hand. You can't sell what you don't have. Now, I'm not suggesting you become a distributor and carry enormous amounts of inventory. You probably don't have the space to stock it, or the ability to keep track of it and keep it fresh, or even the capital to tie up into it. But inside of the Profit Fuel training, we recommend a number of different inventory levels to carry based upon how many patient visits you're seeing each week. And so if you're interested in more on that, go to the Profit Fuel page on our site and dig in on some of that material. In the meantime, carry a reasonable inventory. And a good inventory to carry is be prepared that 10% of the patients that you see each month are going to take you up on purchasing your nutritional recommendation on a recurrent basis. And about a third of the patients that you recommend start nutrition are going to take and purchase some, if not the entire recommendation. So have enough on hand, at least for a week or a two weeks worth of a supply, so that you can confidently say to a patient, I have this here for you. I recommend it. Get started today. And then the fourth thing is have a professional display. You can't sell somebody what you don't show them. If they don't see that you have it, how on earth are they going to know about it? So we've got to intake correctly. We've got to ask the right questions of our patients. We've got to display it properly so that it looks professional and it looks like you're serious. Now, displays are twofold. We need to display it and show it and be proud that we carry this product, but we only want to display branded, high quality, professional products that are not sold anywhere else but healthcare professionals like you. This isn't the time to display anything that could be purchased down the road at GNC or worse, inside the grocery store, okay? Display your professionally distributed products in a professional display. And think about the displays that you're attracted to in retail. They're not cluttered, right? There's just a few clear suggestions of what somebody might like to purchase, easily displayed, professionally lit, and it's kept nice and neat and clean. There's no dust on it, and it's regularly stocked and turned over and reorganized and reassembled to be neatly stacked together. You also don't want to have too much, right? You don't want to be a mile wide and an inch deep. The last thing you want to do is have them go, is this Dr. Walmart here or is this Dr. Jones? I thought it was Dr. Jones' office, but this place looks like Walmart. Don't be a mile wide and an inch deep. Pick your battles and carry those products that are only distributed through healthcare professionals like you. Display them professionally, well-lit, clean, neatly displayed things. That will stimulate patients asking you about your nutritional recommendations. And a good display is worth its weight in gold, my friends. And finally, the last thing is, don't sell, just recommend. Remember, inside of Profit Fuel, we're always talking about this. You're only recommending what's best for the patient. When a patient indicates to you on their intake form that they've got high cholesterol and they've got muscle pain and they're on Lipitor and a variety of other cholesterol busting drugs, okay? It's in their best interest for you to recommend a high quality omega-3 fatty acid to hopefully negate their need for that drug and to lower their cholesterol naturally. You only make that recommendation when you intake correctly and when the patient understands it's not about selling them a product, it's about recommending them something that they can get their best possible outcome with your care. If you've got any head trash around this, please get rid of it right now. Patients want you to recommend things that improve their outcome. Don't ever recommend or be caught recommending something that's not about them and about their outcome with your care at your office. If you've got trouble with this, develop a little stump speech. And here's how I always did it. I'd say, Mrs. Jones, based on my assessment of your condition, your stage of care right now, the exam we did, as well as the intake form that you filled out, I'm recommending X, Y, and Z as my nutritional recommendation to help you solve this problem. It's going to speak directly to the problem you came in here with, and it's going to help us approach this problem from a chiropractic point of view, from a nutritional point of view, and then I also would incorporate a rehab point of view. That was my practice. But develop your little stump speech, the way in which you introduce your recommendation, so you can say it with confidence every single time. My friends, take a look at next week's Whiteboard Wednesdays. We're going to drill deeper into intake. Intake is so critical. Thanks for your time today. And don't forget, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you like what you see here. And make sure that you're alerted every time we upload a new video for Whiteboard Wednesdays. Thanks. Enjoy.